Alright, so we are on our way to investigate a misunderstood organization known as Scientology. If you haven't heard about them, they're
a cult?
They're not a cult.
Misunderstood group of people.
They're just misunderstood. I actually contacted them and they called me twice already.
They have Zach's number.
They have my number. They have my full name. But yeah, we're gonna go check it out, see if it lives up to the rumors. And Thomas says it's a cult.
Is it not? So this is our hidden camera. It's on Zach's bag.
All right, so Chin, we need your camera definitely if they allow us to record.
Yeah.
Let's go. They got security.
We can go into the underground tunnel.
Bro, they have a security guard.
Oh my god. We're so fucking dead if they
actually kill us. Yeah, we might actually be killed here.
I'm Zachary.
You're Zachary.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. So what you're gonna do, I'm just gonna ask you to sanitize your hands here. Perfect. This sensor
is going to go up
a little bit.
You guys still mind me asking how old are you guys?
I'm 16. 17.
Okay. What time is it?
I guess correctly.
I don't know.
Perfect, guys. This is it, right? People love to know how to do each other, okay?
Yeah, cool. Yeah, I'm Greg. Yeah. What's your name?
Linus.
Linus, and you're...
Oh, you can call me Will.
Will, yeah. Nice to meet you guys. All right, so we're going to give you a little bit of details on what Scientology is all about, how to help you guys, okay?
All right, guys, so are you guys in the same house, or...?
No.
Okay.
We're just like...
So we're going to have to maintain some social distancing with the seats. So you guys can pick your seats here, and we're going to be getting
started.
Oh, yeah. You can help yourself. You've got coffee, water, cupcakes.
Ooh.
Help yourself some snacks.
Thank you.
Yeah. Anyway, guys, so this is basically a short little event which goes over some of the things because we just reopened. We're reopening today.
We're going to have some time to talk after the event. The event lasts about 45 minutes to an hour. Okay. And this is just something that we have to go through just so that people can come into the church right at the moment. But,
what's the bridge?
The bridge is actually, okay, so in Scientology,
so like it builds up like good work-life habits, kind of. It sets you up to be a good, like, what do you call it? Like version of yourself. Not really version, but like it just makes you, I don't know what I'm saying, never mind.
Basically, you're on the right track. What it does is it helps you rediscover yourself more and more, little by little, gradient by gradient. You're improving your ability to rediscover yourself. Like study, for instance, right? There's an exact technique that you can apply that'll allow you to be able to absorb any knowledge and become expert at anything, right? And if you know those basic principles of study and how the mind operates, you can apply them and you can actually get huge success out of it. There was a major discovery that the founder of Scientology made. He developed a technology which was able to basically uncover unconscious memory. Or maybe it was before you were born and you had a painful experience while you were in the womb. All of those types of experiences, they're all below the level of consciousness, and it's hard for the individual to recall that memory. So he was actually able to get a person to recall that information and bringing up into the conscious memory so he can re-experience it like it's just a memory. And the power that has is it restores ability. Every unconscious memory has subliminal commands.
So, Greg, are you like a pastor of some sort of here?
No, I'm a staff member.
Okay.
So my basic job here is to talk to new people and find out what's going on in their life and see how Scientology can immediately make changes, right? There's no pushing, there's nothing like that. There's no authoritarianism. I'm here just basically trying to help you make changes in your life so that you can see some success, right?
I'm pretty intrigued, honestly. But maybe it's the cupcake stuff.
So I'm going to count to three, and then I'm going to have all you guys say, let's rock and roll and cheer. And that's all we're going to do. All right. And go.
Let's rock and roll!
Thank you very much. On behalf of all of Vancouver Org, it is my great honor to welcome you back into church. So of course our staff are fully trained in the use of D7, and I thought you'd like a real life look of what you saw on screen. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Awesome, okay. Whoa. Yeah. So we've got Justice in the suit. Yeah. Yeah. Wow. Hardcore.
Yeah.
So this is the gear we're using for fogging. We've got the hazmat suit, goggles, respirator. I'd like to introduce you to him now. Yeah. Come on in. Yeah. There we go. Yeah. Perfect. So these guys are doing an incredible job of helping to keep the org safe and clean top to bottom every single day.
And so that's all like a lot of different activities that we do upstairs. Yeah. And then down here is all about people getting interested and getting on board with what it's all about, just to find out whether it is for them, if it's something that they enjoy, right? Because we know that it's a personal choice. It's not something that you can force on anybody to, you know, improve conditions in their life.
Yes.
Right? It was under his reading. Various different types of professions, right?
Yes.
He was a writer mostly. But he was also an adventurer, he was a ship's captain, he was a Navy in the war, he researched on drugs, so many things. Like, he also knew how to fly like a barnstorm. This is just his biography, right? He's some of the books. And these are all the lectures, some of the lectures that he did. Yeah, of course. So, like, with regards to so you guys okay? You need water or anything?
Oh, no, we got water.
You want water?
Yeah.
No, you guys are good? Okay. So, guys, I just wanted to get to know you guys a little bit and see if I can answer all your questions. And, you know, see whether you guys can find out for yourself whether Scientology is something that you want to look at further. So let's start off. What bad things have you heard?
There's some people refer to it as like a cult.
Okay. Yeah. Now, there's a negative connotation with the word.
Yeah.
And yeah, it does get out that there's this idea that it's like that there's a negative connotation, but that's really just critics that are being critics, honestly. And a cult is usually a secretive, closed-in group. We're not closed in. Anybody can come in. You guys are here right now. And, you know, anybody can come and go as they please. And we're very similar in some ways to Buddhism.
Yes, I saw that when you were talking about the being present.
Yeah, trying to be in the present moment.
All right.
I really appreciate you guys coming in.
Yeah, no, thank you.
Hope you had a good time. Hope we answered your questions.
Thanks for the cupcakes.
You're good.
Do you guys like hold services, like church, for example, like on the weekends?
Or yes. Yeah, we do. We have a Sunday service, which is, I don't know what time it is this week, because we're still getting on the line of opening up. But usually it's at lunchtime.
Okay.
And then we also have free events that we invite people to every time. Seminars to teach people about business or money or just improving conditions of life. A lot of those are great.
Okay, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care.
I said ask him for a tour.
God damn. He asked him for a tour. He gave us a tour.
He gave us a tour of the first fucking floor. There's three more layers that we haven't seen.
Bro, they're hiding shit. I swear. Okay, so we just finished the Scientology thing. The people there were pretty nice, and the presentation we watched was actually, you know, somewhat entertaining. It was okay. The thing that gets me though is that Scientology is kind of a scam for starters. Like, the deeper you get into it, the more money you're dropping. So, a lifetime membership for Scientology is 5,000 USD. In addition to whatever else, they give you books and stuff, right? And these things correspond to a respective course. And each course/book costs maybe $50 as well. So, Scientology is really just a big money milking machine. The building we were in has 4 levels, 4 stories. We got a quick tour of the first floor, but our guide said there are more things up in the upper and lower levels that we didn't get to see. So it's kind of sus. Like, where is this money coming from, right?
Well, how many organized religion is?
Yeah,
it's just all about money.
And then they're asking about donations too. It's just insane how much money they're pulling, and they don't even show us all the facilities too.
It's all older, like
white people.
Yeah, older white people. They had these presentations. I'm sorry, but dude, their videos barely seem to have anything to do with Scientology. It seemed like it was just ads.
I didn't learn anything about Scientology other than Flag. We have to talk about Flag. It's like a freaking hotel for these guys.
Bro, it's literally, it's just to push money. It's just...